China commissions its largest amphibious assault ship, which is expected to be deployed in the South China Sea. The South China Morning Post reports the ship can carry an estimated 30 helicopters and hundreds of troops. Observers say the ship, called the Hainan, could play a strategic role in the disputed waters where China's territorial claims. Meanwhile, the Philippine Coast Guard and the Bureau of Fisheries conducted maritime exercises in the West Philippine Sea last Saturday. In an online forum, a U.S. defense consultant urged the Philippines and the United States to conduct joint patrols along with other Southeast Asian nations.
Combined Vietnamese, Philippine Coast Guard patrols in the area of Julian Felipe Reef will deter any further aggression there. I also think if you were to invite the U.S. Coast Guard to go with you, that would send a very strong signal as well.
Last week, Manila filed two new diplomatic protests against Beijing over the illegal and lingering presence of Chinese ships in Philippine waters. It has vowed to continuously file diplomatic actions until the vessels leave the country's exclusive economic zone. Manila should take the lead in protecting the West Philippine Sea from China's incursions. That assertion coming from Philippine Ambassador to the U.S., Jose Manuel Romualdez. He says while the U.S. will support the Philippines in its maritime issue with China, it must make the first move in confronting Beijing's activities in its territory. The U.S. has also repeatedly said it would uphold its mutual defense treaty with the Philippines and resist China's pressure in the region.
If anything happens in the Philippines, the United States is also very much obligated, and they have clearly stated that they will. But it will take the Philippines to take the lead. In other words, they will not make any moves unless the Philippines says so. The Philippines has to take the lead on when it comes to these things. Any moves that are being made will have to be coming from the Philippines, and the United States will support it.
Malacanang Defense President Duterte's friendly ties with China amid escalating tensions in Philippine waters. Duterte spokesman Harry Roque says issues on territorial rights in the West Philippine Sea have worsened way before Duterte assumed the presidency. Roque maintains Duterte will continue improving his bilateral relations with China and just set aside conflicts deemed impossible to resolve.
Punto lang po sa debate kung sino ang namigay ng teritoryo sa mga dayuhan, hindi po si Presidente Duterte yan. Nadatnan na po yan ni Presidente Duterte. Nang siya po'y dumating, nawala na sa atin ang Scarborough Shoal. Nang siya po'y dumating, ginawa na ng China yung mga artificial islands doon sa ating exclusive economic zone. At nung siya po'y dumating, narito na po itong batas neto na talagang sinabi ng Korte Suprema ay hindi labag sa ating saligang batas. At sino po ang sumulat ng desisyon na nagsabi na yung pagkawala ng ating internal waters, territorial sea, ay sang-ayon sa saligang batas? Wala pong iba kundi si Senior Justice Antonio Carpio.